Hi guys. So in last video, we were talking about this util classes. In that, what we did, we created one rest util class. Inside that, we added some two generic get methods. Okay. And this is what we have added. And we saw like if any user is having just one string, but from that, just nothing is there. So they can use this get method. If user is having any headers, then they can pass this in the form of map object and it will work accordingly. Okay. So this is what two things we saw. Now in this video, we are going to learn one post request. Okay. So now as we know, we have one method like post here. This is used to create user, register any user. Okay. Okay. So in that post, what is this? Is the base URL. This is the resource. Okay. / users resource. And this is what the body we need to provide. Okay. So in this, we will create one method, post method, that will be very generic. In that, we user can provide this URL and they will provide this body, okay, in this same format, okay. So then if they will hit, it will add up one user, new user, okay. So let me go and create this first, okay. This video will be a bit long because we will be doing many things and this is very important also. I think you need to concentrate you need to put some high concentration while going through this video, or else you can watch it 2-3 times, you'll understand it. If you'll not understand any concept, just put in comment. I'll try to explain the same thing in different ways. Okay. So we'll create one post method. Okay. Now what this will accept? It will accept one URL, it will accept and one body, because body is required. Okay, in post request, so we can put it like string body. Okay. Now where we need to pass that body, right? We need to pass body dot body, and this is what the body thing we will be passing it over here. Anyway, that is same. And instead of get, we will be using post. Okay, perfectly fine. Now let's go and create one dummy test and try to use this one. Okay, so now let's go. Here is our test, create user, add user. Okay, so in this our URL is this only, perfectly fine. Now we need to create one where is that rest util objects, right? Because inside that only we have our method, post method, right? So util is equal to new rest util. Okay, rest utils class. Perfectly fine. Let me the name was in capital rest it was, so that's what it is suggesting, to make it capital. Okay, perfectly fine. Now using this util method, util reference, util what we have created above dot post. Okay, in this two parameters required. One is URL, that is already we are passing, but this need body, and in what form it needs this body, right? In this format, right? So to generate it, what we will do, we'll create one method. Okay, in that method, it will means we will define all the variable names and we will be passing it from some external source. Okay, like in real time, what we will be doing, we will be adding our test data in this resource format, but currently we'll create one dummy method. Inside that only we will provide, but this method will be generic. To create Pojo class, this method will be generic. Okay, so how many different Pojo you need to create? For that you need to create separate methods. Okay, so in our case, to have this users, to create user, we need to create this JSON bond. So for this, what we'll do, we'll go to user Pojo, because this is the user main thing, because we need to create all, right? That's what we'll go, and here we will know how to use our this getters and setters also. Okay, so we'll write public, and return type will be string. Okay, because we need in the form of string, right? Get user payload, okay? Get user payload. Okay, now what we'll do, first we'll create what and all is required, okay? So in this, what and all required, ID field required, name is required, date of birth is required, post office address details, office address, and other things are required, okay? So we'll create one instance of, so that we can use setters of that particular object, the Pujo class, to set these values, okay? Now we can do here, first we'll create one, which one? Office address object, okay? So what was the class name we have given for that Pujo? Office address Pujo, right? So we'll write here office address Pujo. Address Pujo. So office address is equal to new. Let me copy this, okay? Paste it. Like this is what we have instantiated this. Okay. Now this office address is there, right? Now in this office address, what and all data we need to provide, right? So building, address line one, address line two, landmark, card ID, and PIN, right? Right. So what we'll do, we'll go here and we'll use the setters what we have created in our office address. Let me show you here. See, set building number. So this is what the method we have created, right? These are the setters. Set address line one, get address line one, set address line one, then set address line two. So this is what we will be using it, okay? Here. Now, so let me copy this and dot set building number, right? This is what the first one is. So this is what the building number is, okay? Now in this building number, we need to provide some integer value, okay? Because this setter, it accepts some int value. See here, you can see like int value is there. See here, int value is there. So here some integer value we will be providing. So what we can do, we can directly pass it over here, or we can keep our test data somewhere else, okay? So what I'll do, I'll provide test data from here because we want to make it generic. So whatever test data user will provide, so it will create that JSON object, okay? That JSON object in the form of a string it should return, okay, for different values. So to make it generic, we need to fetch this data from somewhere, okay? So as you can see, like we are trying to get every data in the form of, like, suppose if user want to take this, then this data will be defined. So it is like key value pairs, okay? So what we can do, we can pass here one map object, okay? Map object, and this will be in the form of a string, comma, a string, and then map, okay? Map instead of map, let me write it test data, okay? Now it is perfect. Test data, okay? Now, here, control V dot get we can do, okay? Because map object, whatever that get method is there, and whatever key you will pass over here, it will fetch you that value. So our aim is to get this one, like building number. So let me paste it here, okay? Now you can see like this map is in the form of a string, but here this method accepts integer value. As you can see here, it is asking for integer value. So to convert any string, we can use like integer dot parse int, okay? Integer dot parse int, okay? Just see, now it is perfectly fine. So whatever value will be passing in the form of a string, okay, it will just convert it into integer and it will set in this variable, okay? Set building number, it will set to building number, okay? So this is what one good thing is there for this. Now you can tell like why we have not written here integer. So directly we can pass integer, right? Because why I have not written here, because we are passing different values, okay? Somewhere we need to pass integer, somewhere we can pass as a string value. That's what I have made it in a string, because majority of the places we are passing a string. And it is easy to convert from a string to integer by using this integer.parseInt method, okay? Now, similarly, so you said building is there, right? Set building number. Now we need to do other one. Okay. So let me copy this. This address dot set address line one. Perfect. The next one is address line one. Okay. And address line one also we can get it from that map object. Okay. Is data dot get here office address line one, right? Address one, that's right. Not address one, because this is the address one and here also it is same. So just uniquely identify it, we can write like office address. Okay, office address one. Perfect. You can give any variable name based on your convenience, you can give anything. Okay, like then we need to provide it here office address two. Okay, then we have to provide, what is the next one? Next one is like address line one, address line two, then landmark card ID pin. Okay, then this is landmark. Okay, the next one is card ID, and the next one is pin. Okay, so now, so it will take the pin. Why it is taking in the form of OHO? Because we are using this, so we need to change this also, right? Because address line one, then this will be like address line two, and this one will be like landmark, right? Set landmark. Okay, let me set landmark. Perfect. Okay, this is not required. Perfectly fine. Okay, then this one is like card ID, right? Set card ID. Perfect. Then this one will be set pin. Okay, perfectly fine. Again, see, this set pin is of type integer. See, you can see here, it is like integer. Okay, so we need to pass integer value. So we are getting providing every data in the form of string, right? So we need to parse it. Okay, so let me copy this same integer dot parse int. Just we can convert it into string integer. Okay, see, now perfectly fine. So this is what one block data got created, right? So this block is now complete. Now we have to add these details, okay, in the similar way. So for that, I have added here, just I'll copy paste here so that we can save little time. So this is what the office details we set, and then after we can create this one. Okay, here one interesting thing I'm going to talk. Okay, so first see, office address object we created, right? Now to go for this home address, we need to create one instance of home address. Okay, so in the similar fashion, we can create like home address pojo. Okay, home address pojo instance, then only we can use these getters and setters, right? So currently don't worry about this errors, it will go off once we'll provide all the data. So home equal to new, just here. Perfectly fine, right? Now inside this home, what we did, set home address, set Aadhaar, set this we did. Okay, now why it is throwing error? Oh, here is a mistake, spelling mistake. Test data. See, here we are getting house number from this map object. Okay, whatever map object we will be providing, from there we can get like one variable. This is like one map object, it is containing all the information. Okay, and this information anybody can provide it from anywhere. So whatever value they'll provide, based on that, it will create that JSON. Okay, so this is like very generic. Okay, we will be not doing any changes over here. Okay, whatever data we can provide from outside, it will create. Okay, so that's what we are making it too generic. Okay, now till home pin number we gave. Okay, now you can see here is like we have this office address. See, this is what one address details object is there, JSON object. Inside that we have house number, Aadhaar number, address line one, address line two, landmark, pin, and this also belongs to that only. This is called nested JSON. Okay, so this also we need to set it. So it means in this home address we need to set this also, this office address. Okay, so this is what this office address is, right? So now let's go type here home dot set office address, somewhere set as will be there. See, this is there, right? And which office address, this is what that instance we have created, right? Just copy this and paste it over here. Perfectly fine. So now till here what we have done, we created this much. Okay, now what we are going to do, we'll add these three. Okay, so now to add those three, what we can do, we can create this user pozo. Okay, one object of this user pozo, because we have given name this as user pozo. Okay, this is what the JSON, and it is like user pozo. So user pozo and all getters and setters we have created inside this user pozo only, right? See, get ID, set ID, get name, set name, get DOB, set DOB, like get home address, set home address. Okay, so that's what we can create one instance of this object, and you can use it like, so user is equal to new user pozo. Okay, perfectly fine. Now what and all we need to add, user dot set ID, first one is ID. Okay, now test data dot get ID we can give, right? So we'll provide it from outside. Okay, now see, this is also same thing, like set ID is seeking for data type as integer, but here it is, we are passing it as a string, so we need to convert it. Okay, so just we'll pass it integer dot parseInt, just make it like this. See, now perfectly fine. What is that error? Oh, it is expecting one more brace. Okay, perfectly fine. Now user dot set name, right? Set name. So test data dot get will provide name from outside, and that name will get and set it over here. Okay, now for user dot set date of birth. Okay, so that date of birth also test data dot get DOB. okay, date of birth. Okay, perfectly fine. So this name you can give anything, just you need to pass it when you're from outside, you'll be passing this name should be similar to that, then only it will work. Okay, now one more thing we need to add inside this user object is like address details. Okay, so user dot set address details, see, set address details, and what is the type of address? So this is like one, it is expecting one parameter, and the data type of that parameter should be home address pozo. Okay, so just select this, and here we need to pass the home address pozo. So what is the object we have created for home address? This is what we have created, right? So this is what we will be providing it over here. Now we are done with creating all this long pozo. Okay, this is perfectly fine, and we are now good to go. One more thing, like, see, we have created this, but we are returning here a string. Okay, so how we can make this, convert this into a string? Okay, so there is one dependency. Okay, JSON. Okay, that JSON will do conversion for you. Okay, so in Postman under dependency, you can add this. Okay, this I have already added. You can add it. Okay, so this is what the JSON is. Okay, and this code also I have added it over here. So see, one JSON object will create, and there is one method to JSON we can convert it. Okay, so let me go and paste it over here. Perfectly fine. Now let me import this. Perfect. See, and what is the Which is like this is the main object, right? It is holding all the informations. Okay, so we can pass it over here. Okay, so what it will do, you know, this will convert this user object, whatever user object, whatever this JSON we have created, right, in the form of a string, and it will return that. Okay, using this we can get that payload, and just this payload we need to pass it in our test. Okay, so now to get that, what we can do, we need to create one instance of this, because this generate, this get user payload we have created inside this class. Okay, so we need to get the instance of this class to call this method, right? So just we can put this like users equal to new user pose. Okay, perfectly fine. Now we need to import that. Perfectly fine. Now users dot get user payload, this is what we are interested in. Okay, then what it will do, it will give in the form of a string. Okay, return type of that is a string payload. Okay, string payload is equal to this. Okay, now this is perfectly fine, and this payload we need to just provide it over here. Okay, now this method we called it, right? But it is expecting some test data, and that the type of test data should be map, and that map object should be holding each and every information what we are looking here. Okay, so what we can do, we can quickly create one map object, and we can provide all the details over here only. But in real time, what we can create in real time, what we will be doing, we will be creating some test data inside this resources folder. We have one resource folder, right? Okay, currently we don't have. I'll create one resource folder. Inside that, we will be passing data. But for time being, just I am adding one map object over here, and I'll add all the information, necessary information, what is required inside that this class. Okay, this method. Okay, so now let me go. I have given that here. Just let me copy this. So this details I'll be giving in this video. If you want, you can refer that also. Okay, see what. So what I did, I have created one map object. Okay, this map object I've created, and the name I've given it is a test data, and this like has map reference it will be holding, and that data type and the type will be like string. Okay, so now test data dot put, if you want to store some key value pairs in this map object, what we need to provide the key, and we need to provide the value. Okay, so now what is the first one it is expecting? Okay, the first value what it is expecting is like building number. Okay, see, this string should be very important, and it should be same. Okay, so building number, suppose we give building number 1. Now the next what it is expecting, office address 1. Okay, so for that office address 1, then office address 2. Okay, perfectly fine. Then office address we can write like main road 1, and then this office main road 2. Okay, just this is one example I'm adding. So just see here what I am doing. Okay, now the next one it is expecting landmark, and then card ID, and then pin. Okay, so next card ID is there, employee ID, okay, let it be there like, and then pin. Okay, just pin it is a landmark it is expecting, right? One landmark also it is a landmark is like opposite to Gandhi Bazar. Okay, landmark we give. Now what is the other thing it is expecting? It is expecting pin number, right? So we can provide here pin also. Pin, let me add that test data dot put. Okay, now what is the key it is expecting? Key it is expecting pin, and the value can be, so for pin number what we can do like 8989. Okay, this is what we can pass. Let me put one semicolon over here. Okay, so now the office details, whatever required we provided here. Now we are going to provide house details. Okay, see this office address still here we gave out. Now in house, what and all information it was expecting? It is expecting house number. Okay, so this house number is there, and house number is we'll give one only. Okay, one house number one. Then after Aadhaar number, the key should be same. Aadhaar number, perfectly fine. So Aadhaar number is same. So this is what the Aadhaar number. So what I can give 1001. Okay, this is what the Aadhaar number gave us. Then after what it is expecting, office address line one. Okay, then we can go here, office address line one, office address line two, then landmark. Just a second. Yeah, landmark, and then this home pin number. Okay, so landmark and this home pin number, perfectly fine. Okay, now what else it is expecting? Then office address it will set, whatever these details we have provided over here, it will automatically. So for that we need to do anything. Now in user, what and all information is required? First one is ID, then name, then date of birth, right? So first one will go and we give, see, date of birth is already there, their name is already there, one ID is missing, right? This data.id. okay, sorry, just data.put key, it will be ID, and the value will be one or two, but this data is will all miss in our developer has created this application, in that this data automatically it gets created. Okay, so just we have given some random value, so don't worry about that. Okay, now we are done with whatever it was in need. We are done with everything. Now we can call this method arams. Okay, now string payload it will, and it is expecting this test data. Okay, now test data it will give this, and we can hit this post request and we can store it response is equal to util dot, let me put this, perfectly fine, and then response dot pretty print. Okay, let me go and check. See, everything looks good. We'll see if any error will come, we'll debug it and we'll check it. Okay, now let me right click, run it, test, test ng. Hope things work fine. Okay, so this is what the ID, see, this is what the details we have passed it over here. Okay, but it didn't work because we are not seeing. See, we have given this response, but it is not printing any response. It means this data didn't get created. Okay, let me check whether this got created or not. Okay, see, earlier we were having only one with ID 28 and still having only one. So what is the mistake we did? Okay, this mistake is like plain text. No, sorry, one content type we need to add it. Okay, so just go here. Dot accept content type application.json. okay, so let me go here, content type application.json, we can pass it like this only. So dot content type, let me copy it. Just we need to add the content type. Okay, content type, then it will work, because according to our requirement it should accept, it should return in the form of this JSON. That's what this content type is required. Okay, now let me go and run. We'll see. Now initially we saw like how many users are there, only one user is there, and that is also having ID 28. Okay, let me run it. Hope this time it should work perfect. See what it did, it went with this data, and this is what the response we got, right? Perfectly fine. In this response, it is telling like with ID 31 and with these details it has created. Okay, so this is what the details we have provided, right? Name as KR, this is my name. So date of birth, and then these other information. So whatever information we have given, right? Office one, so office one. See, this has created. Now we can go here and we can check. See, earlier we were having only one user with ID as 28. Okay, now we can hit this again. And we should get one more. See, ID 31, okay? ID 31, and this is what the details we have provided, right? This is what the Aadhaar number, building number, and other things, whatever details we have provided, everything came over here, okay? So this is like one good thing. So this is what this post method will work, okay? Just what we did, we created one generic this method. In this generic post method, in this, we need to pass the URL, that is like APIs, and then body. And to create body, what we have done, we have created one method. Inside that method, we are expecting a map object which should hold all the information, these information, what and all information we will be requiring to create this JSON object. Then we created one JSON object to convert it in the form of a string and return it. Okay, so it returned it over here in our test method. So here it returned that payload, and then after we using this util rest util instance, we hit that post request providing the URL. So this is what the URL was there, and this is what the payload is coming from this method. Okay, so this is, see how it is simple. It look complex a bit, but two times if you practice, no, it will be like you'll not face anything. Okay, it will like very easy. So that's it for this video, guys. Hope you understood everything. And one more thing, like if you're not understanding anything, no, just you post in the post questions in comments. I'll try to answer this. Okay. Or this, it will be easy, man. No need to worry. Thank you. Thanks a lot, guys. Bye bye.